Hello viewers, today we're going to talk about something just about any car in the world has, the tires. These patches of rubbers are the only contact point between your vehicle and the road beneath it. But despite that, many of us take the tires for granted and don't think much about them. This is at least until the time comes to replace them, which is when you'll realize there are many options available. Apart from different brands, you'll have to choose between several sizes, which may be sometimes confusing. So in this video, we'll learn all about tire sizes and key features when buying a new set. But before we do that, make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that notification button. At the tire sidewall, there's a series of numbers and letters, with each of them carrying different information. These can tell a lot about size, its construction, and the way the manufacturer predicted its usage. This is at least if you know where to look and how to decipher these alphanumerical combos once you have found them. To make understanding this easier, I'll highlight all the K numbers on the random tire so we can see what each of them means. We'll start with this section, which speaks about the dimension of the tire. The first three numbers here are the tire width, which is this length here, measured in millimeters. This tells us how wide is the tire surface that touches the road. In this case, this will be 225 millimeters. The next number, just behind the slash mark, is the tire's aspect ratio. It will tell us how high the tire sidewall is, which is this dimension here. However, this is not given in millimeters or inches. Instead, this is the percentage of the tire's width. So in this case, this would be 45% of the 25 millimeters, which equates to roughly 100 millimeters, if I've done my maths correctly. Following the aspect ratio, there is a letter here representing the tire's construction. Some of you may not know this, but all tires have steel wires and cords inside, giving them strength and structural integrity. So to show this, we'll have to cut the tire in half, but not this one, obviously. As you may see here, there are steel plies or strings running from one side of the tire to another. Tires that have this arrangement are called radial tires, which is what the R stands for. This proved to be the best possible configuration, and basically all modern cars use radial tires. There are also cross-ply tires, which are only used on some old-timers and trailers. This will usually have no letter here at all. The final number in the sequence is the diameter of the rim on which the tire is to be fitted, given in inches. In this case, we'll have a 17-inch rim and a corresponding tire. As obvious as it may sound, you always want to get the tire that will match your rims. There is no way of fitting a tire to a different sized rim. Next, somewhere just behind the rim size, you'll find two or three numbers and one letter. The numbers are what is called a load index, which tells us about the maximum weight the tire can carry without the risk of breaking apart. The higher this number is, the more weight you can safely put on the tire. However, you can't easily tell how much weight it holds just by looking at this figure. Instead, you need a reference chart that shows you what the load index rating means. This particular tire has a load capability of 91, which means that the tire can hold up to 1,356 pounds. The letter behind the load index represents the speed rating, which is the top speed it may safely achieve. Tires with higher speed ratings provide more control at higher speeds and can handle the heat better. But as with load index, you can tell a lot from this letter without a corresponding chart, which you can find in the description. Most vehicles on the road have tires with speed ratings ranging anywhere from P or S for pickup trucks to V or Y for fast sports cars. The next thing to look for is the DOT symbol, which is short for Department of Transportation. To be road legal, every tire in the US has to have it, which means it meets all the safety and technical requirements set by this regulator. Just next to the DOT symbol, you'll find the tire identification number, or TIN. This is, in a way, a serial number that contains various manufacturing details. While most of these digits serve for manufacturer's internal classification, the last four are very important for us as car owners. These represent the week and the year in which the tire was made. In this case, this was the 7th week in the 2020. Lastly, you have a UTQG number, which stands for Uniform Tire Quality Grading. This is a rating system developed by the Department of Transportation, which tells us about tire's traction, temperature grading, and tread wear. The traction grade shows the wet traction capability of a tire as performed during controlled testing. The AA-rated tire provides the best traction when driving on wet roads. The temperature grade shows the ability of tire to handle and dissipate the heat. The higher the temperature grade, the more capable the tire is to operate at faster speeds. A temperature grade of A can handle speeds over 115 miles per hour. The tread wear grade shows how the tire responded to government's testing designed to reveal the expected wear of the tire's tread. The higher this number is, the longer the tire should last. Still, the actual wear of any tire is going to depend on far more than what this rating is. Tire performance relies heavily on how the vehicle is driven, the type of roads it is used on, and several other factors. With all the basics covered, there is only one question left unanswered. What if you want to switch to a different tire size? There are many reasons for this, including not being happy how the car rides with the tires you have on it now, the current dimension not being available anymore, or just wanting to fit a set of bigger rims. But when switching to another dimension, the new tires will have to fit your car perfectly. Otherwise, this might offset its handling and ruin its road comfort, and that is something you definitely don't want to do. For a start, if fitting wider tires, you need to make sure they will not rub against the suspension components or wheel arches. In addition, have in mind that much wider tires will put additional stress on suspension components and will make the steering noticeably heavier. Another key thing here is the aspect ratio, or the height of the tire. The thing is that, despite the variations of the tire width or the rim size, you'll want the overall outside diameter of the tire to remain the same. Let me show you what I'm on about by comparing these two wheels. At first, they appear to be the same, but look closer and you'll notice that the one to the left has a smaller rim than this one to the right. But despite this difference, the outside diameter of both wheels is roughly the same. This is because the tire on the smaller rim has a much higher, chunkier side, which compensates for the difference. However, working all this out in real life can be boring and sometimes a bit difficult, as it is easy to get lost in all the maths. The easiest way of getting around this problem is by checking the optional tire sizes given by the manufacturer. You can find these values in your owner's manual or on the sticker located inside the driver's side door jamb. By choosing one of those optional dimensions, you're sure to get the tires that fit your car perfectly. That's it for today. I'm quite sure you'll now understand everything about tire sizes. But if something is left unanswered, leave us a question in the comments or go to our community forum. You can find the link in the description.